The Parliament outreach attracted the region's members of Parliament, district chairpersons, chief administrative officers, district councillors and resident district commissioners, among others.
Honourable ministers should take that it is true the local governments are really bleeding. They are bleeding. All these leaders here are in trouble. Now you imagine yourselves, actually the members of Parliament, you are earning slightly higher, but you are having challenges. Then how about us who are almost earning nothing?
That we work with the local leadership in ensuring that the projects which NRM government designs for the region are implemented. An example is Usmid project. It pains me a lot when you see Gulu City moving to phase 4 of Usmid, but Fort Portal City has issues. You don't see the roads we see in other cities.
Among issues discussed was poor funding of local governments and lack of facilitation to deliver services.
But facilitation actually has gone down to nothing. Actually, we are not facilitated. District chairpersons, you can talk, we have no vehicles. We actually go borders. The speakers, they have nothing.
Richard Rabuhinga, the president of Uganda Local Government Association, revealed that local leaders are still being paid using the salary scale that was passed in 2011, where a district chairperson earns 1.7 million shillings, while sub-county leaders are paid 370,000 shillings, district councillors are paid 250,000 shillings.
If a member of parliament gets 100 million, just an example, they don't see pay. The vice chairperson, the councillor, get something towards 4-5 million, 10 million.
The Uganda Local Government Association president says if the MPs do not put efforts in filling gaps in salary disparities, service delivery will continue to suffer.
In my view, yes, the right honourable speaker yesterday said for the next 3 years we shouldn't expect anything. But my view would be, consider purely that as members of parliament, it will be the better interest of members of parliament to work towards filling the gap so that everybody feels comfortable where he or she is.
We've not become people-centered, we have become self-centered, and we are only talking about our involvements. Yes, even RDCs have issues of involvements, but this wouldn't be the right forum for us to talk about ourselves. It should have been people-centered.
Badege Layibi Division MP Martin Ujara Mapenduzi challenged the local leaders to concentrate on increasing their revenue base before they can think of their emoluments.
Instead of fighting, let us get together. We started looking at how to push up our local revenue. By the time Chairman Mao left, the district was collecting about 480. When I became chairman of Gulu, from the 480, by the time I left, Gulu District was collecting over 1 billion. What did we do?
Matter is known, and we hope that things can improve in the future. For me, I know the predicament, and I'm very, very sympathetic to councillors.
Report by John Antusingwire for the news in Fort Portal.